such a small child.
Such a cutie. I'm happy not waiting, you guys.
I feel like a movie star.
Okay, hello you guys. So today I'm having my friends over and we're going to be doing a natural hair video. So I decided to just prep up some snacks for them. We're gonna have some Doritos, muffins, bananas. I'm also going to make them cool smoothies if they want. If they want some ice cream. Got a really large 5 liter, no, actually it's a 4 liter tub of ice cream strawberry. So if they need some ice cream, that's what we're gonna have. I also am going to make them some tuna melt sandwiches and some, I thought I had chicken patties in here. Oh yeah, there we go, chicken patties. So that's what I'm gonna make for them in a little while. But I'm so excited that we're doing this video. And oh yes, I also got something exciting. Okay, so I'm gonna make them some pina colada maybe. And put in a little bit of red stag, black cherry. Or if they want, I can give them some Moscato. No, this is actually Merlot. Where's my Moscato? Yes, there we go. But it's almost finished because, you know, when Dave is here, he likes to have some Moscato. But yeah, so we're gonna have tons of fun. Tons of fun. And that's it. To my channel, SunKissHilda in the house. I'm so excited to be making this video today because I have my two lovely princesses right here. Yes. Okay, so to my left, that's Chantel.
Hi guys.
And to my right, that's lovely Bella.
Hi.
Okay, so I've got a lot of questions from you guys from Snapchat, and you're like, how do you do your natural hair? What's your journey been like? Blah, 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 blah. So I thought, you know what? I'm not a natural hair guru, but I do have a couple of friends who've been natural for quite some time, and it's great to just sit down and have this video with them and ask them some of their experiences, you know, answer a few questions, and I'll be part of the team as well. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and let's get started. Okay, so I'll start with Bella.
Okay.
What made you go natural, girl?
It was a whole bunch of things that actually made that go natural. Number one, because me and perm did not work. My hair would just not grow from like past a certain point when I had perm hair. And then it always used to break, like it would grow to a certain length and then it would break in the middle, like right here.
Yeah.
So it would be all gone and then I have to like, you know, try to like force it into a ponytail and the ponytail was like this.
But I was wrong.
So I just went and chopped everything off to the length of the middle, which was like about this much. Really, I just cut it because I didn't want to do a lot of things. And I also, I've always admired people who are bald. Like girls who have like bald heads. I love it. And I'm like, you know what? I can't go that far because I know the shape of my head. So I'm like, okay, I'll stick with this length. And pretty much that's what happened. And then from there, I just...
We will skip Chantel because she's been natural forever. Well done, girl. That ain't her question. Okay, so I'm not going to be natural now, though.
Now it's been 4 years.
Yeah. Guys, I'm 3 years, so up top. Ooh. And up top for being natural forever. Okay, so for both of you guys, how has been your experience in being natural?
Mm-hmm.
How does it feel like waking up every day having to deal with all of this?
Well, you should tell you.
Sometimes I don't deal with it. That's like, just wake up and go. Keep it funky, keep it pushing. But yeah, you know, like, I mean, you get used. Like, you know, when it's all you know and all you do, it comes a lifestyle, so it's not so much of a drag. Like, oh, I have to do it. Like, you know, it's like natural. Like, okay, I'm waking up, I need to put these products in, do this the night before in order for my hair to look nice.
Yes.
Like, you know what I mean? I have this event coming up, so that's pre-planned for how I do my hair.
Like today.
That's pre-planned.
Like 48 hours before, you know.
I mean, I'll be honest, there's some days you're like so tired. You don't feel like doing that extra energy for a flat twist out or a wash again. Like, you know, you just wanna let it be.
Exactly, exactly.
But overall, it's like, it's not there, you know, especially when it comes to second nature.
Yeah. When I went natural, it was also because I wanted to spend less. Okay. I always used to get a perm, like every month or something like that, and then I'll have a weave, and I used to go to like expensive salons to get the weaves.
Yep.
So it was a lot of money for me, and I still say, like, since I went natural, my expenses on hair have gone down tremendously for me, because I refuse to be like a product junkie.
That's what you said.
Yeah.
I refuse.
I'm breaking my pocket.
Once I went natural, I was like, I'm just going to do simple things. So it was like, you know, just shea butter, wash, you know, like, get like a, what do they call them? Like a ouchless band or something like that.
Yeah.
And, you know, just push it back and stuff, or do this. Exactly. This was my go-to hairstyle when I started.
This is the go-to hairstyle.
When you wake up in the morning and you
don't
feel like you're either applying that
water
or that.
Hair water.
Natural, like, I just want to do minimal things.
Well, I'm just like you as well. I don't use a lot of products in my hair, just because it's so expensive, and not every product will work for everybody.
Yeah.
So I try to stick to, like, if I have an olive oil or argan oil or my Ecostyler girl. Or if we got the Ecostyler, like, you know, slick that on. You ready to go? And the monsters. Exactly. It's true. Well, and by the way, those of you who live in St. John's, Sally's now has Ecostyler gel. So get it before it runs out.
And
because they only have 3 bottles.
Like, another thing to point out is that we live on an island, so it's expensive.
Exactly. Yeah.
Like, when I live in Toronto, and like the Ecostyler gel that she just showed me, I think that's about like $2 or something like that. And here, that small one is about like $5 or $6. So like, there's quite a price difference.
And they only have only like 3 or 4 bottles.
They have
them
there. Yeah.
So you need to get them right now.
I think they think they're like only 3 black.
It's like, no. I know my friend is looking for like a good hair grease. I'm like,
exactly.
Yeah. I mean, like, him that took it.
I will take your product. I am not joking.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're gonna talk about hair expectations, because all naturals think that your hair is supposed to be flowy and straight and all of that. But what we need to start accepting is our hair is kinky, it's coily, it's curly, and we have to accept it. It's different from any other race in the world. And it takes a lot of work, but that's what comes with it, with your race and what you are.
Exactly.
So let's talk about expectations, because for me, when I became natural, I was like, in 5 years, my hair gonna be like up to my waistline.
Exactly.
But it ain't. It's still up to here. And even like when you straighten it, it shrinks. Like, if any kind of water, moisture, anything goes onto your hair, it just reverts and puffs. How do you guys deal with, let's say it's a rainy day, and the expectations that you had that your hair was gonna be so long and straight, and it's not. How do you deal with that and accepting your curl pattern and all of that?
shame.
Yeah, you like, can never. Oh, yeah, you like,
how for me?
Yeah.
Like, if it's raining, if my hair is like in a natural style, I don't mind as much because moisture. How?
Exactly.
Yeah. A little drizzle. A lot of drizzle. How? Like.
And now it's like hurting me.
I'm not joking.
A little.
A lot of drizzle. To
be fair, this.
Yeah. A lot of drizzle. Like somebody's got a plastic bag and
yeah.
I don't try. A little sprinkle doesn't hurt at all.
Yes.
Like,
yep.
It keeps your crowns looking fresh and clean. And you know, there's nothing wrong with that. But if you're just flat pass or straight in, and
oh, yeah,
that's when it comes tricky.
Yeah.
But with that, I just, you know, try my best to carry a hair wrap in my bag. Okay. So if I know I'm dashing out real quick, I'll put a hair wrap on, keep an umbrella close down, and like make it to the next destination. And your hair wrap so flimsy, you can just pull it up, stuff it in your purse, and like it's still good to go, and you saved your
from coming out the
corn. Yeah. No, like for me, when it's raining, I love it.
Yeah.
Because my hair is really dry. Like, I think like just being here has like eaten up my moisture and stuff like that. My hair gets really, really dry very quickly. So when it rains, like I actually like it because I know I'm gonna go home and it's gonna be like all
soft. Yeah.
Exactly. And like my expectations when I went natural, like everybody, when we went natural, where did we go? YouTube.
That's your friend.
So I made the mistake of like not following people who had like my
hair
stuff. Like, I mean, I don't even like hair typing, but I guess I fall under like 4C and stuff like that, like really coarse and stuff. So, but I was following maybe like the 3C.
Yeah.
Just like, let me try and, you know, let me try and twist out. Bam. You know, like, let me try watching go. Bam. So, like, my hair expectations were that. Like, and most of the, actually, like, on YouTube, what happened was, every 2 years, like, someone started following when they had a big chop, 2 year mark comes, and it's like,
boom,
yeah,
like,
yeah. Like that. And I'm just like, where is my own? Like, I'm going on 3 years now. Why am I still just right here?
You
know? So then I rewatched their videos, which is actually a good technique to get us to watch those videos. So I rewatched their videos, watching like another YouTuber that say, you know what, follow someone with your texture, then you know, like at least there'll be like similarities and stuff like that, which it'd still be different, but there'll be similarities.
Okay.
And then I followed someone with my texture. And honestly, like they say, shea butter, you know, moisture.
Yeah.
And since then, honestly,
amazing.
Oh my God, I love it. Yes, my hair is not, it's still not at wrap strap length 4 years later, but I love it.
Yeah.
And it's growing at its own pace.
Right.
You know,
and actually it is on bra strap length. It's just that your coil is so tight, but when you pull it down, it reaches your strap. You know what I mean? Like, actually, when you're washing your hair with conditioner, you see your true length.
No, that is
because
true.
Because when I'm washing
stretches.
My hair, I actually love like,
these questions is so that people realize that you need to learn to love your texture
and your
hair. That exactly. So her texture and my texture and her texture
different.
Are totally different, but it's totally awesome to look at each other and be like, your hair is gorgeous because it doesn't look like anybody else's hair.
Exactly.
And whatever you do to it, you do your own twist out. I do my own twist out. She does a twist out. It all comes out differently. So it doesn't always have to come out looking like the person on YouTube, but how it comes out for you is the way it's supposed to be because of your hair texture, you know what I mean? So just rock whatever style you have, pretty much. Yeah, because I'm learning to love my hair too. I used to have a lot of trouble with moisture and all of that. Once I got the right product, you guys, exactly. I love, like, my hair is not even super dry.
You learn to try and error, because, like, as time went on, I found that, like, whereas a day later, my moisture is gone, but now I can keep the moisture in for, like, a week.
Right. Yeah.
Like, 1 week and my hair is still, like, ooh.
Feeling good.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, I just think you have to really, really take your time and find proper products.
That's true.
You know, because that's the main key. Everyone's hair is different.
That's true.
So you have to find what works best for you. And like, you will waste a little bit of money.
You will. What's your go-to hairstyle? Just because we've talked about different textures and so forth, there's something that really works for each and every one of us. You know, something that you can rock, you know, in 2 minutes or even an hour. What's your go-to hairstyle?
A high bun.
Yes, okay.
Just have eco style gel.
Eco style.
Water.
Push, push, push.
High and done.
Yes.
For me, my go-to style, I would say, is a flat twist-up. But let's say, if I didn't do it the night before, I woke up, and I still want her to be really nice, I will do a quick kind of wash and go chunky twist. Like, you know, you just rinse her out. Put a little curling custard or something and just put it in big chunky twist sections and then take it out, separate it a little bit, and it keeps your hair stretched out and, you know, enhances your curl pattern and you're good to go. Like, and that only will take you an hour. Like, you know, so it's not too bad, like a little quick go-to.
People are like,
I know,
I'm getting
on
schedule.
Like,
do you know what happens to me? Is that I'll start out, I'll twist, I'll be like, yeah, tomorrow I'm gonna rock this, yes, whatever. I'll twist my, I'll take my time, okay, twist my hair, do it, put like a satin scarf and stuff like that, and I wake up in the morning, and usually it's because I have church the next day, so I wanna
get up.
Wake up in the morning, start taking out the stuff, my hair did not dry.
Just blow dry it for like 10 minutes, not even 10 minutes, because I just grab a YouTube blow dryer and I wake up
on a low setting.
When we came in, she had like chips and stuff.
That's how we roll.
She just rolled, she knows how to choose.
Yeah.